You're watching the free version of Silhouette Essentials. For projects and footage, head to BorisFX.com for the premium download.
Let's just pick an area here where we see some markers showing up. So we'll just paint this area for this part of the class in the demo, and then I'll take you over to my final. So this is just the traditional manual paint. I'm just going to bring down the gamma a little bit more. I'm going to click C for the clone tool and remove the remnants of this marker. I'm going to zoom out just a little bit, turn on the overlays in the viewer. Down here, I can see my roto shapes here, and I just want to mention this is because I have the show shapes on, checked in the paint tab here. If I uncheck that, then they will no longer appear. All right, so let's start with this marker here. So I have a clean frame here, and I'm just going to pull from the frame after it. So just open up my frame box here. Do some manual lining up. Make sure that my brush is at 100% softness. That's how I like to work. And I'm going to click the alpha here. So I have paint in the alpha. And just paint it out. This is an easy part. And then I get to where the hand intersects. I'm just going to use the interactive tool. I want to make a couple different transformations here. I want to move my source and I want to rotate it. So I'm going to click the period where I want to have the pivot and make my adjustments. All right, when it's lined up, I just deactivate the interactive and paint away. And then it shows up again here. I'm going to use this clean frame of the hand here as my source. And it looks like my previous transformations with the interactive is working for this frame as well. And then that's done. I'll just kind of go through and see what else is showing up. And then we'll want to use the previous frame for this paint here. So we have to line up this hand. I'm going to reset my interactive, my transforms. Enable that again. Click the period key where my cursor is. Looks like my frame got reset too, so I'll just change that back to what it was. It looks like a little bit of a hard edge here, so I'm just going to bring down my opacity just for a little bit of blending, and then back to 100%. And for this frame, I will use the frame after. It looks like a marker's peeking through right here, and instead of just painting that out, I can probably just go back up to in paint node here and make my shape a little bit bigger. And back to the paint node, and now you can see it's no longer showing up here. And we'll just paint out the rest of the marker near the hat. I'm going to reset my transforms make my frame the frame before. And I'm just using the arrow keys because I'm not really lining up the hat. I just want to be near the hat. This is a little more complicated. I want to make sure I get that nice edge here. And we're done. Let's just take a quick look at the channels to make sure we got all of the marker. Alt B, Alt R, Alt G. Okay, that's done. So now it's time to take you through my final tree. So once more, here's the original plate with the markers and the tape pieces and the targets. And let's look at our rendered final. All of that was painted out within the area of the GMAT we made. I can go up in here and take a snapshot. Here's the original. Let's go to a frame where there's a lot of information in there. Snapshot here, and then the final, and then we can do a vertical wipe. So you can see everything is clean. I'll disable the wipe, and then I'll take you down through the node tree. So here's where all my in-paint shapes and fills were made. You can see all the different layers. And then we have our Roto node with the GMAT. And then we have our paint node here. And this is just the areas that needed paint after the in-paint. So it really wasn't that much. If you zoom in here and you compare this frame, actually I'll just turn off the overlays and make another snapshot and then go to the paint node and do another wipe. There was just a few sections here and where the markers intersected with the character on the upper torso. So I'll just disable that wipe again. And then as I get down here, I've added an alpha threshold node. So I want to just cycle through the alpha here. So it has both the GMAT and where I did all the paint work. And I'm just going to go to the Roto node here and I'm going to disable that because I don't want that to show up in the alpha channel of my paint. So here's the output and here's the final. And then over in this tree here, I have a copy of this Roto node. And then I have an alpha to color. That means I've put the alpha channel into all the other channels. And then I have my output. So this is a 4-channel matte render for the compositor to use to help with limiting the extraction area just to the areas that we painted. So now when we're ready to render, we can actually do this at the same time. And I've already rendered these out, but I'll just show you how you can do multiple render. So you can't actually select them both, like click this output paint, which I've labeled them, and then shift click. That doesn't really work. What I find that works is if you just select them both, drag and select, and then you go down to the render window here, click render, and you have selected output nodes. And the work range is what we want. And then we make sure that preview is checked and then we can see our render. So if we click render, now you can see that both output nodes are rendering and it alternates with each frame. So I'll cancel this since we've already rendered it. Next up is a mini class with another marker removal shot, but this time I will be using the Silhouette plugin in Nuke.